There's a train coming. I'll be heading to San Diego. Alright, heapy nag. Take a look. Yeah, these big old trains, big old cranes, always kind of fascinate me a little bit. Let's take a look at it. Great big huge thing, working alongside the train track here, putting in whatever they're putting in, these big girders I suppose. Anyway, let's take a little look at this thing. Big old cables there. Zoom in up there. See how these pulleys work. Driver's cab there. And there's tools for the job. Grease gun. And something to clean his window with, his windscreen. What's that? International Union of Operating Engineers. It's union guys, I guess. Take a look in his cab there. I'm not going to go climbing around on it, but you can see. Look at these chain links. I got size 13 feet. Them links are massive. Big shackles. Big toys, huh? Yeah, come this way, down.
Good boy.
Let's go around the crane. Big old jib. Yeah, I've drove some big diggers before, but track diggers, but never had a go at one of these. Yeah, I think the biggest one I ever, biggest track digger I drove was a 20 ton Caterpillar. That's back in the UK when I used to do a bit of construction work. But yeah. That's a big old crane. Pretty nice. Let's see what other machines have got here. There's a nice new bit of kit. Telescopic forklift. I don't know what you guys in the US call them. But, I have driven similar in the UK. Bunch of stuff to go with a crane. A nice bit of kit. So some nice properties up here. That big old John Deere dragging them tines along behind it. And leveling out the road there that they're putting in. Nice John Deere. Always had a fondness for tractors and machinery. I've owned a few tractors in my time. Mostly the old Massey Fergusons. It's a handy little crane. Say a little, it's a good size. See what the cab's like in there. Just up periscope. Little device there up on the jib for seeing how strong the wind is. Zoom in on that. Putting in some sort of road parallel to the train track there, going through the lagoon, and you got the train tracks there, and you've got police over there doing something. Don't know what the cops are doing. Looks like traffic accident, and got the surfers behind there. The biker bar over there. Zoom in on the old bikes. Yeah, that makes me miss my bikes. I rode bikes for all my life, basically, apart from the last few years that I've been over here. But I got to go through all the aggro getting a bike license, I guess. Maybe I'll get another one in the future before I'm too old. Yeah, nice old wooden bridge there. That's what the trains currently go over. Some interesting engineering going on. Hoops of rebar. They're coated in it. Good thick. I don't know what if it's paint or plastic coating. Piles with the spikes added to them. I guess that's to hold concrete. They've been pile driven in. All that rebar that they've put around the around those piles. It's a serious amount of rebar. See how clean the water is here. They do tend to look after the water here. It looks pretty clean to me. I would swim in it. In fact, I have been in that part down there, peanut swimming. There's some kids fishing over there, so. Tide's going out. Concrete spacers, whatever they're called. Giant buckets. JP. Get on them, Peanut. We gotta go across this stuff. Thank you. that's where the machinery is over there, and the lagoon mostly that side, and the ocean. There's some surfers out there having fun. Well, that's it. Just a little video of me and old Peanut there mooching about on a Sunday. Just checking out the place. Alright, catch you later, guys.